Hello and welcome to worship. We're so glad we can continue to worship together this way. A few announcements about our life together. Today we celebrate the baptism of our Lord Sunday and a reminder of the gift that baptism is to all of us in calling and claiming us as God's children. Part of being God's children is doing the business of the church sometimes. All baptized and confirmed members of American Lutheran Church are invited in the next 2 weeks to participate in the decision-making of the church through our annual pre-annual meeting. That takes place next Sunday at 9:30. It's an opportunity to look over our annual report and ask any questions that you may have before we gather again on Sunday, January 30th at 9:30 and have our annual meeting, which includes updates on ministries in American, an opportunity to vote on our budget, and to make some plans or share some dreams going forward. So as baptized and confirmed members of American Lutheran Church, we invite you to those meetings the next two Sundays at 9:30 a.m. We have many prayer concerns to share with you today. Prayers for Lynn Oldenburg as he is entering hospice care, for Janine Corneliuson, who is hospitalized still after a fall, Linda Bailing, who is recovering from COVID, and Frankie Swope's brother, John, who lives in Oklahoma and is currently battling COVID. We pray also for Jerry Lenander, who was hospitalized this week. We keep in our prayers our greater community as our COVID numbers surge for those in our schools and in our medical facilities as well. We welcome all who are listening on the radio. Today's broadcast is sponsored by Art and Marian Eichlin to the glory of God. Let's take a moment now to prepare our hearts and minds for worship. We continue with confession and forgiveness. Blessed be the Holy Trinity, one God who creates us, redeems us, and calls us by name. Amen. Let us confess our sin in the presence of God and one another. Most merciful God, we confess that we have sinned against you and your beloved children. We have turned our faces away from your glory when it did not appear as we expected. We have rejected your word when it made us confront ourselves. We have failed to show hospitality to those you called us to welcome. Accept our repentance for these things we have done and the things we have left undone. For the sake of Jesus Christ, have mercy on us, forgive us, and lead us, that we may bathe in the glory of your Son, born among us, and reflect your love for all creation. Amen. Rejoice in this good news. In Christ Jesus, our sins are forgiven, and we are descendants of the Most High, adopted into the household of Christ and inheritors of eternal life. Live as freed and forgiven children of God. Amen. We sing now our opening hymn, number 445, Wash, O God, Our Sons and Daughters. Thank you.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. Let us pray. Almighty God, you anointed Jesus at his baptism with the Holy Spirit and revealed him as your beloved Son. Keep all who are born of water and the Spirit faithful in your service, that we may know, that we may rejoice to be called children of God through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Our first reading is from Isaiah. But now thus says the Lord, he who created you, O Jacob, he who formed you, O Israel, do not fear, for I have redeemed you. I have called you by name, you are mine. When you pass through the waters, I will be with you, and through the rivers, they shall not overwhelm you. When you walk through fire, you shall not be burned, and the flame shall not consume you. For I am the Lord your God, the Holy One of Israel, your Savior. I give Egypt as your ransom, Ethiopia and Seba in exchange for you. Because you are precious in my sight, and honored, and I love you, I give people in return for you, nations in exchange for your life. Do not fear, for I am with you. I will bring your offspring from the east, and from the west I will gather you. I will say to the north, give them up, and to the south, do not withhold. Bring my sons from far away, and my daughters from the end of the earth. Everyone who is called by my name, whom I created for my glory, whom I formed and made. Word of God, word of life. Thanks be to God. Psalm 29. Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings, ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. Ascribe to the Lord the glory of his name. Worship the Lord in holy splendor. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord over mighty waters. The voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord is full of majesty. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. He makes Lebanon skip like a calf, and Syrian like a young wild ox. The voice of the Lord flashes forth flames of fire. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness. The Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord causes the oaks to whirl and strips the forest bare. And in his temple all say, glory! The Lord sits enthroned over the flood. The Lord sits enthroned as king forever. May the Lord give strength to his people. May the Lord bless his people with peace. Here ends the reading.
The Gospel according to Luke. Glory to you, O Lord. As the people were filled with expectation, and all were questioning in their hearts concerning John, whether he might be the Messiah, John answered all of them by saying, I baptize you with water, but one who is more powerful than I is coming. I am not worthy to untie the thong of his sandals. He will baptize you with the Holy Spirit and fire. His winnowing fork is in his hand, to clear his threshing floor, and to gather the wheat into his granary, but the chaff he will burn with unquenchable fire. Now when all the people were baptized, and when Jesus also had been baptized and was praying, the heaven was opened, and the Holy Spirit descended upon him in bodily form like a dove, and a voice came from heaven, You are my Son, the Beloved. With you I am well pleased. The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, O Christ. Dear friends in Christ, grace, mercy, and peace to you from God our Father and our Lord and Savior Jesus the Christ. Amen. I am haunted by waters. The last line of a favorite movie of mine, A River Runs Through It, a movie based on a book written by Norman MacLean. The movie doesn't tell you why exactly Mr. McLean is haunted by waters, but it does give you some ideas. The waters are a setting of a way of life that is no more. If you've seen the movie, you know it centers around fly fishing, around the Blackfoot River area near Missoula. Much of the fly fishing takes place with Norman's brother Paul and his father. Those are great times in the author's life, but by the time he writes that novel, a memoir really, those times are but a distant memory. The author may also be haunted by waters because it's on those waters of the Blackfoot that he forged a relationship with his brother Paul, his brother who had a violent and tragic end due to a problem with gambling. All of us who confess the Christian faith are, in a sense, haunted by waters. Our scriptural and religious imaginations are filled with images of water. It's the waters that draw us together today as we celebrate Jesus' baptism and remember our own. Our ancestors in the faith, the Israelites, were also a people who returned again and again to the waters. The Psalms, the hymnal of the Israelites, begins with an image of water, as Psalm 1 describes those who walk in the way of the Lord as those who are like trees planted by streams of living water. And then during the exile, that time when the Israelites were forcibly taken away from their land, their temple was destroyed, God calls them back to Jerusalem, to a life that will be restored. How does God do it? With the promise of water. The prophet Isaiah describes their return to Israel as one in which God will pour water on the thirsty land and streams on the dry ground. Water on the thirsty land, streams on the dry ground. For those people who lived in a dry land, water is always an issue. So these images of bountiful, overflowing water stir the imagination and make their minds soar with the promises of God. Since I've moved to Montana, I've noticed that Montanans have that same sensibility about water. Not so true back in the upper Midwest where I grew up. Sometimes it can rain too much. In the year 2000, when I moved from Iowa to Billings, we had the month of June where we lived in Decorah, northeast Iowa, where it rained 10 inches in 1 month. Boxes of books that I'd packed for the move were sitting in our basement, were soaked by the waters of our flooded basement. Actually saved me a little work because I didn't have to move those boxes. We couldn't take any more rain, and people were complaining about it. In Montana, it's different. I don't know that I've ever heard anyone complain about the rain in Montana. People tend to be happy when it's raining. And on those rainy days when I'm at the hardware store or the grocery store, I overhear conversations about million-dollar rains, and people seem to have an extra spring in their steps. We who live in a parched land, like those ancient Israelites, know what it is to have our imagination stirred by the waters. But water is an ambiguous force. It's not always good, certainly. In our first reading, we hear from the prophet Isaiah of different waters, of passing through dark waters, of rivers that threaten to overwhelm us. These waters are not the waters of a bountiful rain. They're not the waters of a river running over parched land. These waters are threatening. They represent darkness and evil. As well as speaking of the wonders of water, the Bible also speaks of water as a dark and destructive force. One of the first Bible stories our children learn is that of Noah and the Ark, a story really centered around water, all that rain. We've made it into a cute, nice story. I remember when my children were younger, we had this kind of soft and cuddly Noah's Ark with this cute little family, these adorable animals you could take in and out of that ark. We've made the story into really a G-rated one, where if you really read it, it's definitely rated R for what I would say violence and intense trauma. It's a story of great destruction and anger as God is incensed with the people's behavior, angry enough to wipe out the whole earth, except for this one little family and pairs of animals. It's a story that makes us wonder if God is for us or against us. This is also the time of year when I have memories of waters of the frozen variety. I didn't make the trip this year, but there have been those trips back to Minnesota around Christmas, driving trips across the frozen tundra of Montana and North Dakota and then into Minnesota, and those trips can get scary on those roads. You know what it's like, snow blowing hard enough to make the visibility near zero, then a semi drives by, and the visibility pretty much is zero for a few terrifying seconds. We do know the goodness of water, but we're also wary about it, as we know as well its destructive power. But there are those waters that rise above all others. Today is the day that we celebrate those waters, the waters of baptism, waters of the River Jordan in which Jesus was baptized, the waters of our own baptismal font that splashed the foreheads of seven different babies this past year, babies that were baptized during a pandemic. There are the waters of all those baptismal fonts spread all around the state and our country that mark your foreheads when you were young as children of God. Brothers and sisters in Christ, there is no ambiguity. There is no wondering about the waters of baptism. These waters will always remind us of the gifts of God, the gifts of forgiveness and of eternal life. These waters will always promise us new life, even when we experience death and loss. God speaks to us out of the waters of our baptisms, and those waters can do great things. We see the power of God's voice, God speaking over the waters. In Psalm 29, that psalm that we read responsively, the psalmist tells us that the voice of the Lord is powerful. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. The voice of the Lord shakes the wilderness of Kadesh. The voice of the Lord causes the mighty oak trees to whirl and strips the forest bare. God speaks over the waters, not only to show the world the power of God's voice, but God speaks as well to each one of you. So when you remember your baptisms, you reach back to hear that voice that calls you out of the waters, the voice that proclaims that you are a good creation of God, one of the beloved children of God's kingdom. This voice promises you God's presence amidst all the different waters of life. In your own life, you know those emotional floods and blizzards that can hit, threatening to destroy you and take you down. Out of the waters of your baptism, God's voice speaks above those destructive waters, promising you they will not overwhelm you, promising you that you will come to know life that is abundant and good. The American poet Langston Hughes has a line where he speaks of the waters, saying, "I've known rivers, ancient dusky rivers. My soul has grown deep like the rivers. I've known rivers, ancient dusky rivers. My soul has grown deep like the rivers." God's promise to you is of a soul that will grow deep like the rivers, deep into the rivers of forgiveness, deep into the rivers of the abundant life that God promises you. And finally, God promises you a soul that will grow deep into the rivers of eternity. Amen. We now hear our hymn of the day, Baptized in Water.
Baptized in water, sealed by the Spirit, cleansed by the blood of Christ our King, heirs of salvation, trusting His promise, faithfully now. Sign God's children, joyfully now God's praises we sing.
We are grateful for your offerings, and last week Pastor Elizabeth gave thanks for your providing of the heat that warms our building during these cold winter months. And I want to thank you today for the gift of light. It's a dark time of the year, and as I come to the church in the morning or leave in the evening and it's dark outside, I find the lights of the church building or the lights of the parking lot give a sense of being cheerful and hopeful during a dark time. So thank you for the gift of light, the light that is a symbol of Christ, the light that shines in the darkness. Thank you for your generosity.
Together we profess our faith in the words of the Apostles' Creed. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, God's only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day, he rose again. He ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. And now the Spirit of the Lord is poured upon us in abundance. So we are so bold as to pray for the church, the world, and all that God has made. Gracious God, you have called and claimed us as your own. Make us bold to care for one another as siblings in Christ and family in service to the world. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God who leads in peace, guide the leaders of all nations that they may find a way forward with humility and that their actions desire peace and prosperity for all people. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, who forgives our sins, forgive us for the ways we turn away from the realities that surround us, as we fail in our creation care, in our compassionate care for neighbor and stranger, and our care for the generations that follow us. Help us do better. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God, who knows our names, we pray today for all who are hurting in body, mind, or spirit, especially Lynn Oldenburg, Janine Corneliuson, Jerry Lenander, Linda Bailing, and Frankie's brother, John, for all we name in our hearts. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And God, who is steadfast, help us to cling to the promises of our baptism, including the promise to proclaim your good news through word and deed and to serve all people following the example of Jesus. May it be so. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Since we have such great hope in your promises, O God, we lift these and all our prayers to you in confidence and faith through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
We pray now the prayer that Christ taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen.
And now receive the benediction. God, who leads you in pathways of righteousness, who rejoices over you, and who calls you by name, bless your going out and your coming in, this day and forever. Amen. We now hear our sending hymn, Let All Things Now Living.
Go with Christ into the weary world and share the good news. Thanks be to God. Alleluia. Alleluia.